Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's time to begin our service tonight.
Amen.
Welcome to Thursday night worship service, New Testament Christian Church, Columbus, Ohio. Amen. It's time to have church.
Amen.
Let's go before the Lord in prayer tonight.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
And worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And let's ask Him to bless tonight in a special way. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray and ask You to move by Your Spirit. We ask You, Father, right now, Lord, to move in this service for Your glory, Lord. We come with our hearts open, with our cups uplifted, Father, asking You to meet every need, Lord, tonight. God, bless this service. Accomplish Your will, Lord. We thank You. We praise You. We give You all the glory and all the honor for what You're going to do tonight, Lord. We open our hearts now, Lord. Have Your way. Meet the needs of Your people. Reach through, Lord, and wherever we are tonight, Lord, we pray that You would speak to us. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Let's make a joyful noise to the Lord tonight. This song was on my heart today, and that is Standing on the Promises of God. Standing on the Promises of God. Amen.
Amen.
Promises of God.
tonight. Say yes and amen. Lord, we give you praise. Your promises, Lord, we thank you for them. And we stand upon them tonight, Lord. Your eternal word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank God for his promises tonight. Amen. And amen. We give God the glory. God, all the praise for his love and his goodness tonight. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's good to be in the house of God. Welcome to church. Welcome to Thursday night service. We invite you just to let go and let God have his way tonight. And we're just believing God for his blessing and for his word this evening. Amen. And I want to take a minute and say thank you to everyone who wished our daughter a happy birthday. Thank you for the love, the care, just the well wishes and the prayers and the thoughts for our partyless party for Jade. Yesterday was her birthday, and we just thank God for her life and thank God for that blessing. Amen. To be able to celebrate another birthday. Amen. So thank you, everyone, for your love and expressions of love. And normally we'd be receiving an offering tonight, and remember, our online giving is open and is working. It is working. And if you'd like to give to the program of God, all you need to do is go to my www.myntcc.org/columbusoh, and there's an online giving button there, and it'll lead you through the steps for giving if you can still support the work of God. And if you're not able to go online and do it that way, you can always contact me, send it in by mail, reach out to me, and we'll work something out. But we appreciate your giving to the work of the Lord, and we thank you for it, and we look to God. All of us are depending upon God in this time, and hopefully a lot of people are stimulated with the government stimulus package, and so maybe you're able to do a little bit more to help the program of God, and hopefully everyone is doing well financially in that regard. And then let me say this, if there's anyone out there who is in need of something, there's anyone out there in our church in Columbus here that is in need of something, all you have to do is call. All you have to do is call. We keep pretty good tabs on people, but if you're out there and you need something, a special need, a special request, even prayer, if it's prayer, call us, send us a text message. If you need prayer, you need help, you're discouraged, something's going on, just let us know. We're here to help. Just because the door of the church is not open to the public does not mean that the phone lines are down, doesn't mean the text down or email, any of those things. We're still open, amen? We're still praying, we're still ministering, we're still working for the glory of God.
Amen.
And so there are still ways to reach out and communicate with us. And so we just encourage you to do that. Reach out if there's a need. And so this Saturday, God willing, and we're going to have another drive-through blessing set up this Saturday from 11 a.m. to 1. 11 to 1 this Saturday will be set up with the drive-through blessings again. We have several boxes of fruit. We have two freezers full of some chicken, some meat, and some other goodies. And we just want to make that available again. That's been a blessing to a lot of people I know. And so just letting you know ahead of time, I'll probably also send a message out to people so that they can receive that. And so that is Saturday, this Saturday, not Friday, not like last week. This is Saturday this time from 11 to 1. So important to follow the instructions here. All right, we don't want you coming up here on Friday thinking that we're going to be here because we're not. All right. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And one more thing on the announcements, we do and have set up a special conference call system, conference calling, to where if there's anyone that you know that is not connected to the internet, we call them disconnected. If you're not connected to the internet and you don't have access to the internet or computer or a smartphone, we have you covered. We have a conference call system set up now where all the person has to do is dial a number and enter a code, and they'll be able to join the phone call. And so it's important, if you know somebody that's out there that is in need of that, and they want to hear a message, they want to receive something from church, but they're not able to, we have an option for that. So just to let you know, that is available. Contact me if you want more information about that. And so, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We've started that call tonight. It may help you, honey, if you go in the other room and see if you can hear better, because you're on the phone. So go in the other room or out, maybe outside even, and see if you can hear it better, so you're not waving at me all night. Thank you. So, praise the Lord. All right, sister's going to sing a special at this time. How many know we need to keep going on for Jesus? Amen?
Amen.
Keep going on for Jesus. All right. Keep going on for Jesus Christ. Amen. And I'm glad we can tonight, and I'm glad we are tonight by the grace of God. Going on for Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Going on for Jesus. Amen. Amen. For what it's worth. Hallelujah. Amen. If you have a Bible tonight, like to turn with us. We're going to be reading some scripture from the book of Exodus. The book of Exodus chapter 17 tonight. Exodus chapter 17, verse 8. Beginning in verse 8. I'd like to read several verses here of scripture. Exodus chapter 17, verse 8. And it reads, "Then came Amalek and fought with Israel in Rephidim. And Moses said unto Joshua, Choose us out men, and go out, fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand. So Joshua did as Moses had said to him, and fought with Amalek, and Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up to the top of the hill. And it came to pass, when Moses held up his hand, that Israel prevailed. And when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hands were heavy, and they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat thereon, and Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands, the one on the one side and the other on the other side, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. And Joshua discomfited Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. And the Lord said unto Moses, write this for a memorial in a book, and rehearse it in the ears of Joshua, for I will utterly put out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. And Moses built an altar, and called the name of it Jehovah Nissi. Jehovah Nissi. And I'd like to read verse 12 for a text tonight. But Moses' hands were heavy, and they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat thereon, and Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands, the one on the other on the one side and the other on the other side, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. Using that as a text tonight, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. And I want to preach to you tonight on the title, Steady Hands Win the Battle. Steady hands win the battle. Let us pray and ask God's blessing. Reverend Aristizabal, please pray, sir.
Father, we're thankful once again for your goodness and your presence.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, in this service. Just have your way, Lord. Bless your messenger as he delivers your word, and bless each and every one of those that are tuning in and listening to what has to be delivered and preached, Lord. Just continue to bless and move in a special way. And we give you all the glory and praise in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. All right. We are on the church site tonight, right? New Testament Christian Church of Ohio. Of course, I'm already getting some messages. I can't find it.
Right.
So hopefully you found it by now. If not, you'll have to watch it later. Exodus 17 and verse 12. And his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. His hands were steady until the going down of the sun. We have a story tonight from the Old Testament about Israel getting into a battle with the Amalekites. And tonight we see the importance of being steady. The importance of being steady in our life. In our life for God, really in a lot of areas of our life, we need to be steady. The word steady means firmly fixed, supported or balanced, not shaking or moving. Speaks to us tonight of something that is solid, something that is fixed. The Bible tells us that the soul that endures to the end shall be saved. Amen. Jesus taught his disciples in many places the importance of being firm, of being balanced, not shaken about and not tossed around, but Jesus many times reminded the disciples of how important it was for them to have a foundation in their life. And no greater foundation than that tonight of the Word of God. Jesus even spoke of his own teachings as being a solid foundation. And that's the only foundation that will protect us and secure us from being destroyed when the wind blows and when the storm comes or when the rain falls. And we know that it does rain on the just and on the unjust tonight. Amen. There's no avoiding circumstances. There's no avoiding the rain. But Jesus said this, he that builds his house upon my sayings and my teachings, the one that hears them and does them, is the one that builds the house upon a firm foundation. And he said, a rock. And although the winds blow and the streams beat vehemently against it, it will not fall Because it's founded upon a rock. God's word is a rock tonight. Amen.
Amen.
It's a rock that we can stand on regardless of the winds that are blowing in the water around us. We can stand and be anchored in Jesus. We can be steady tonight. In a Bible passage, we find Moses doing his best to lead the people to the promised land. God promised Israel their deliverance. He promised them their sustainment. He promised them that they would be brought into a land flowing with milk and honey. But along the way, we know the reality was that there were circumstances along the way. There was issues along the way. There were challenges along the way. All God asked them to be was steady. Steady in their faith. Steady in their resolve to simply believe God and follow Him to the land that He said He would lead them to. He didn't want them to look around and be discouraged or be distracted. All they needed to do was be steady in their faith and their trust in God. Amen.
Amen.
The same God that brought them out of Egypt and brought them into the land and crossed the Red Sea would be the same God to lead them all the way into the promised land. But the Bible tells us, in previous to this Bible reading tonight, read it later, don't read it now, but he tells us about how the Israelites began to complain to Moses. The Bible tells us that they began to complain because they didn't have any water to drink. And it was here that God told Moses to use the rod that he had given him, and the rod that he had used as a covenant way back in before he even went into Egypt. God told Moses to smite a rock in a place named Horeb. And Moses would smite the rock, and out of that rock flowed water for the people to sustain them there in the wilderness. And what a miracle it was that they would be sustained by water flowing from a rock. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. You see, God was not limited. And all they had to do was be steady in their faith to believe, and God could provide anything, anytime, anywhere, in any place. And tonight we need to be reminded of that at times, that no matter what's happening, no matter how dry things look around us, God is still the provider of everything that we need.
Yes.
And He's able to provide and make even something out of nothing if we simply have faith in Him.
Yes.
He made manna rain down from heaven and fed them daily. He caused water to flow from a rock. He protected them with a cloud by day and a fire by night. And it's the same God tonight that I'm coming to you and preaching to you about, that we need to be steady in our faith and resolve, because God has not changed tonight.
Yeah.
He still provides a cloud of protection for His people. He still provides a flame and a fire by night to keep us warm and to illuminate the path before us. He's still able to rain down manna from heaven to meet the need in our lives. And no, He may not rain down physical manna, but the Bible says He owns the cattle on a thousand hills.
Yes.
He's able to provide in ways that you and I can't even begin to comprehend.
Amen.
Because God's in control.
Yes.
I'm talking about being steady tonight. Steady for the Lord. Getting to this part here where the Bible says, after they had witnessed this miracle and after they had complained, the Bible says the Amalekites began to start another battle with the Israelites. And here they were, that the Amalekites came and began to put themselves in a position to fight God's people. And we know that there were many battles that the Israelites would face. Whether tonight it's a financial battle, a physical battle, a spiritual battle, whatever the battle might be, the Word of God shows us that God is faithful.
Yes.
That we have not and will not be tempted above that we are able. But we serve a faithful God tonight. No matter what the temptation might be, He will make a way to escape that we can bear it for His glory.
Amen.
The Bible says in Psalm 34 and verse 19, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all. Yes. Amen.
Yes. Amen.
The Lord delivereth them out of them all. Many are the afflictions, but all of them the Lord delivers from. Amen.
Amen.
And God was going to lead His people to a better place, a land of promise. The Bible tells us that that God's intention was to lead them to a better land, a better country. Even in the book of Hebrews, Paul, writing, describes that they were looking for a country whose builder and maker was God.
Yes.
They were looking for a place that was better. Amen. Aren't you looking for a better situation tonight?
Amen.
And I believe in the heart and soul of people, people are looking for something better. And especially in the times in which we live, we're looking for a better situation. And we're seeing a lot of things come to the surface here in cities and countries and the handling of different things and how ill-prepared people really are for a true crisis. We're looking for something better. Amen. And in all of what's going on, I believe God is trying to lead us to something better.
Yes.
He's trying to get us to be better ourselves. Amen. As individuals. And as He does that, I believe it's then that we can make society better and our cities better. And all the way up to the government levels, we can make things better as we get the goodness of God flowing in our lives. You see, we need to be better, first of all, mentally. God wants us to be better mentally. How do we do that, preacher? We do that by keeping our thoughts stayed upon the Lord. We do that by doing as what Paul said, think on those things. If there be any virtue, if there be any praise, amen. If there be things of good report, things that are lovely, things that are true. Amen. So many times we get our mind thinking on so many things that are not true, things that are not good, things that are not healthy, things that are not even of God. Amen. We need to get better mentally, and it starts by keeping our mind stayed upon the Lord.
Amen.
He said, great peace have they whose mind is stayed on thee. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And tonight we need to be steady in our resolve to stay focused on the right things. God wants us to bring us to a better place spiritually by remaining steadfast and unmovable in the work of God. The scripture says in Psalm 103, verse 2 and 3, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases. Amen. Another place the Bible says where God spoke and said, I am the Lord that healeth thee. Amen. Who's the healer tonight? God is the healer. He's the source of it. We used to sing a bit of, I think it was called a doxology in the old Presbyterian church where I grew up. And we say this slow, monotone chorus of sorts. And it was, praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all ye creatures here below. Praise Him above the heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. And in that, at a very early age, I began to learn that it's from God that all blessings flow.
Yes.
Tonight, our help comes from the Lord. Amen.
Yes.
Our eyes, like David, need to be up on the hills, for that's where our help comes from.
Yes.
That's where our health comes from. That's where our healing comes from tonight.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. Thank God for what the government's doing, but they don't have all the answers tonight.
Yes.
Thank God for what people may do in reaching out and being a blessing and serving. Serving and helping, but you know what? We need more than that tonight. We need help from on high. We need help from the hills of God.
Yes.
Because that's where true healing and true salvation and true satisfaction comes from.
Yes.
Amen. It's still God tonight. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's still God that brings the healing, and God that brings the miracle, and God that brings results. I believe in giving God the credit and honor where it is due tonight. Amen.
Yes.
If you just excuse me for a minute, thank God for New York. Pray for New York. New York needs prayer. New York has always needed prayer, but especially now. And someone made a statement the other day, and I saw this article about the Governor Cuomo making a very bold and a very dangerous statement in a press conference. And you can look this up and check it if you want to. But the governor came out saying how that the numbers are going down and the number of cases have gone down. And he boldly said in this press conference, he said these words. He said, God did not do that. He said, faith did not do that. And he looked around and he said, we did that. And he began to take the credit for the numbers going down in the city of New York. And I heard that. And Brother Whitlock posted something on the internet about it. I said, my God, that is bold. I thought, look out, New York. Because with leadership like that, stealing the credit and not giving God the glory, that's heading down a wrong path.
Yes.
Friend, tonight we need God. It is God that helps. It is God. Amen. Every good gift and every perfect gift comes from above. And if there's a blessing, decrease, if there's help in our lives, we know we're not the author of it, but it's God that made it possible. It's God that said, all right, I'm going to answer prayer, and I'm going to move. It is faith tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is faith that we need, and trust that we need. Yes, we can do our part, and all these things are good, but only if God allows it to work.
Right.
Only if God allows it. Bible says, bless the Lord, O my soul. He forgives. He's the one that heals all of our diseases. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. We're praying for New York, especially people who make statements like that. And he's not the only one. To be fair, there are people like that all around the world tonight who do not give God the glory, who do not give God the credit where it is deserving. Hallelujah. When threatened tonight by the Amalekite battle, as the Amalekites came against the Israelites, they were threatened by another battle, another challenge. When this threat came to the ears, and when Moses got knowledge of it, he did the right thing. He knew exactly what to do. He began to talk to Joshua, and he told Joshua, the servant, he said, Joshua, I want you to gather some mighty men. And he told him to go out and get some mighty men for us. Gather together the best, the strongest. Get some mighty men together. And he sent Joshua and the mighty men into the battle to fight against Amalek. This was taking care of the physical side of the battle. But there was another side to this, another front, if you will. And that was the spiritual front that Moses knew had to be won, because he knew that their weapons would only do so much. He knew that their effort would only go so far. He recognized that without God's blessing upon their efforts, it would not work. It's like what the scripture tells us later, what David would express this same truth. And he was said, unless the Lord watches over the city, the watchman waketh but in vain. Unless the Lord builds the house. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. And this is what Moses realized and believed, that yes, I've got to take care of the physical side of the battle. And there's things I have to do. There's things I have to work on. There's things I have control of. But there's another front that we have no control of, and that is in the supernatural. And that's where we need God's blessing. And that's where we need God's hand and God's favor to move upon our life.
Amen.
And this is what Moses did. He sent them out to take care of the physical front. But Moses went up on the top of the hill with Aaron and Hur. And the Bible says he took the rod of God in his hand. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This was the thing that God had promised. This was a token, if you will, a symbol of God's promises in behalf of Moses. It would be this rod that God would use to prove that God would perform supernatural wonders in his life and on behalf of the people of Israel. It would be this rod that God would use to perform signs and wonders. It was a token, if you will, for Moses to use this rod, and all the plagues and all the things that happened, even lifting it over the Red Sea. He didn't go anywhere without it after this point. He took it with them. And even till the day that he died, he leaned upon the same staff and the same rod, because Moses was steady, leaning upon the promises of Almighty God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he would take this rod, which symbolized God's promises, and he would take it to the top of the hill. And here he would hold up the promises of God, and he would lean on the promise of God and lift it up and say, in so many words, he was showing God, we're believing your promise. We're believing in your provision. We're trusting in your help to win this battle. And the Bible says, as long as his hand was raised in faith, in intercession, the Israelites prevailed against the Amalekites. Hallelujah.
Yes.
What a picture of the power of prayer. What a picture of the power of being steady in our spirituality, being steady in our faith for God, being steady in our focus and our resolve in serving the Lord. As long as his hand was raised, and as long as he kept it up and was steady, The Israelites prevailed. Learn that lesson tonight. As long as you stay focused and stay true and keep the faith, you will prevail.
Amen.
But the Bible says something happened. Moses got weary. Moses got weary. He got tired of holding that rod. He got tired of their interceding in the spirit. An interesting note here. The Bible says nothing about how Joshua and his men got tired. The Bible doesn't tell us at all that they got tired fighting. That anyway, their strength began to withdraw, or their faith began to get weary, or their strength rather get weary. It says nothing about those fighting in the battle getting tired. But it was Moses who got weary. It was this aspect that I believe God wanted us to realize and learn this lesson very well. And that is, it is in the spirit. It is in the supernatural. And fighting the supernatural battles and being steady in our prayer life and being steady in our faith that makes the biggest impact in your life and my life for God. Without prayer, we're nothing. Without prayer, there's no prevailing. And this is what happened when Moses got tired. The scripture says when his hands began to fall and he began to get weary, that when he did this, the Amalekites began to prevail against the Israelites. But when he lifted his hands up, maybe got a burst of energy, the Israelites began to prevail. And I don't know how long this went on for, but maybe as he caught his breath, the Amalekites prevailed, but as he lifted his hands, the Israelites would prevail.
Yes.
And in whatever Aaron and Hur were doing at this time, I don't know what they were doing before they were helping Moses. Hopefully they were praying with him. But they began to realize something. As they looked at the battle going back and forth, they realized Moses needs some support. And Aaron on one side and Hur on the other began to hold up, and they began to stay the hands of Moses, and they held his hands up, the Bible says, until the going down of the sun. Amen. It was this, amen, act of faith, and it was this support that would bring final and total victory over the Amalekites. Hallelujah.
Yes.
When his hands were steady and he got the support that he needed, they were able to overcome the Amalekites. You see, we may get tired in the flesh, but it's in the spirit tonight that we need to continue to be steady. We need to be steady for God. And we need to beware of faintness. And beware of growing faint in the spiritual things. Why is it so many times that it's easier to perform a physical exercise than it is a spiritual exercise? Can I get a witness out there?
Man.
The more spiritual the exercise, the more difficult it is for the flesh. That's why. Why is it that it's easy to stay on a computer for hours? It holds your attention. But it's hard to stay in the Bible for hours. Why is it that it's easy to watch a YouTube video or scroll the Facebook page or watch videos about puppies and horses or whatever other nonsense is going on, but it's hard to sit through a whole church service online for 34 minutes? Without scrolling on to the next thing? Why is it easier to do fleshly things than spiritual things? There's a reason tonight. Why is it easier to cheer for a football game for an hour, but you cannot watch in prayer for an hour? And these are just examples of fleshly things versus spiritual things, but we all in some way can relate to what I'm talking about. How that we found ourselves doing fleshly things that it was no problem at all, but for some reason we get weary. When it's time to read the Bible, when it's time to pray, when it's time to worship, when it's time to do something spiritual, there's a fight, there's a battle that takes place. Moses got weary, amen, but he needed support. Tonight we also need support.
Amen.
We need support to overcome the weariness. We need support to overcome the tired hands. We need support tonight to overcome that fleshly feeling that wants to give up or just wants to rest or just wants to take it easy. But brother and sister, tonight it's when we take it easy that the Amalekites begin to prevail over us. It's when we take it easy and lose the focus and begin to become weak in our faith that we begin to see the Amalekites prevail over us. When Peter was not steady in his focus while walking on the water, he began to sink. When King David was not steady in his pursuit of honoring God's law, he went after Bathsheba. When Moses grew weary of holding his hands up in prayer, the Amalekites began to prevail. And guess what? If it happened to them, it can happen to you and I tonight. Amen. If they needed support, then so do we. Amen. Amen. If Moses needed an Aaron and a Hur, so do we tonight. Yeah. And it may not always be in the form of a brother or a sister on our left or our right, although we need that tonight, church. We need the prayers of one another, the support of one another. Yeah. And if we see our brother getting weak, if we see a sister getting down, come to their aid, lift up their hands, and help them to prevail in the Spirit for Almighty God.
Amen.
We have tools. We have weapons tonight. We have support such as the Bible. Amen. The Bible, the Word of God will help us to stay until the evening. Amen. Prayer tonight will help us to be steady until the evening. Amen. Worship. Amen. Engaging in the online services as we've been doing. It will help us to be steady until the sun goes down. I know it's not the same, but you know, we're making do with it until the time comes and we can meet again. Amen. Amen. I'm with you out there. I want you all to be in the church and be not looking at a camera while I'm preaching. But understand there's still support. The Word of God is not bound. The Word of God is not limited. And if we simply exercise our faith, we'll become stronger and better for the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
We need the Holy Ghost support tonight.
Yes.
Amen. Holy Ghost support will help us to build up our faith. It'll help us to stay steady until the sun goes down.
Yes.
As Moses received help on his right and on his left, thank God tonight there is help for you. There is help for me. Amen. We can be steady until the going down of the sun, as it was in Moses' life. He had to stay steady until the sun went down, until the battle was over, until it was all said and done. He held on to the promises of God. He held on to what God said, I will give you victory, and I will allow you to prevail over the enemy if you simply hold on to me. And tonight is the same. Be warned against weariness. Be warned against, amen, getting lackadaisical or getting lazy in your faith. Stay steady tonight for Almighty God.
Amen.
The option is very clear. The results of not being steady, as Moses shows us, that as his hands lowered, the Amalekites prevailed. And we don't want that, and that is not going to be our portion tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. That is not going to be the portion of those that trust and believe in God. Amen. Those that trust in the Lord, the Bible says, shall be made fat. And I'm not talking physical fat, I'm talking spiritual fat. God is enabled to enlarge our coast. Amen. He is able to enlarge our territory. He's able tonight to make things bigger, to make things better, as we prevail and remain steady for Almighty God. Until when, preacher? Amen. Until COVID-19 is over? No. Until Jesus comes again.
Yes.
Until the sun sets on our life. Until the sun sets on our ministry. Until the sun sets on our calling. Whatever it might be, we need to be steady all the way to the end.
Amen.
Amen. We need hands steady like Moses until the going down of the sun. And thank God tonight we've got support. We've got support from the Word of God. We've got support when we pray. When we draw near unto God, the Bible says He will draw near unto us. We've got support tonight in Holy Ghost power. When's the last time you prayed in the Holy Spirit tonight? Pray in the Holy Ghost, He said over in Jude. But ye beloved, building up your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
We need the Holy Spirit's intervention and intercession in our lives. Because it's the Spirit that prays for us and through us at times when we don't even know what to pray. Have you ever been there? You don't even know what to pray or what to say or how to express in words the things that you're feeling, but you begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. You begin to speak in another tongue. You begin to prevail in the Spirit, and God begins to move in ways that we don't even understand, but we know He's doing it.
Yes.
Amen. Lastly, tonight in Galatians 6, verse 9, I'm going to close here. Galatians 6, verse 9. He said, "And let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not." Yes. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us not be weary in well-doing. Amen. Amen. Don't be weary in doing well. Don't be weary in keeping the faith. Don't be weary in living your life for God, planting one seed at a time, making one step at a time. Don't be weary in the things that you do for God that are well, because He said in due season. There is a due season for the church, a due season for the believer, a due season for everyone that is laboring for Almighty God. Even as a Christian, as you serve the Lord, as you plant or sow seeds of faith and do the right thing in your life, the Bible says, in due season we shall reap if we faint not.
Amen.
They say Rome wasn't built in a day. Trees don't grow overnight. Fruit doesn't come from the tree the next day after you plant the seed in the ground. And a lot of things in life have the application, and so it is in the spiritual realm of things. Don't be weary in waiting. Don't be weary in holding on. Don't be weary, for God promised in due season ye shall reap. Amen and amen. Amen. Do you believe that tonight?
Amen.
He said, if we faint not. If we faint not. Moses and the people reaped the rewards of being steady in their faith and steady in their prayers.
Mm-hmm.
Because they didn't faint, guess what? They reap the rewards of that victory against the Amalekites. My question tonight in closing is, who or what is your Amalekite? What is it that has begun a battle? What is it that has attacked you? Is it fear? Is it doubt? Is it some fleshly thing? Some sin, some lust, something from your past, whatever it might be? What is it that is making an attack against your faith? I want you to know tonight, by God's word, you can be steady until the going down of the sun. If we lean upon the support that God's provided, if we lean upon His word, if we lean upon the power of prayer, if we lean upon the power of the Holy Ghost, if we lean upon the power and support of our brothers and sisters, our pastors, our preachers, our elders, our teachers, if we lean upon their support, we can remain steady and receive the victory until the sun goes down. Amen,
amen.
And amen. Until the going down of the sun, His hands were steady until the going down of the sun. Let us pray tonight. As we close in prayer, I want to pray a prayer together. I want everyone to join me tonight in prayer as we believe God for strength, for a refreshing, a renewal in this service as a result of these words tonight. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank You, we praise You for Your love and mercy. God, we thank You for the words of this story and the words of inspiration tonight that You have imparted to us. And Father, tonight I come before Your throne of mercy to obtain grace and help in the time of need. I bring, Lord, our church before You tonight. I bring each one listening before You tonight. I bring each one that will hear these words tonight, that God, by the Holy Spirit, that You would just touch their heart and set them free. Anyone that is weary tonight, I pray that You would bring the power of the Holy Spirit to move upon them. Lord, breathe upon Your church. Breathe upon Your people tonight, Lord. Help those that are weary to lift up their hands again and use the support that You have given to us, God, that, Lord, we may prevail over all the power of the enemy. We thank you tonight that you've given us power, you've given us strength, you've given us victory. Yes. That, Lord, we don't have to lean upon our own understanding tonight, but we can trust in you with all of our heart. Yes. And tonight we believe you for a blessing. We believe you for renewal. Yes. We believe you, Lord, for strength to keep our hands up. Yes. Until the sun goes down. Yes. Until it's all said and done. Yes. Until there's total victory for your church and for your people in whatever area of their life they need it tonight. We believe you tonight, and we join together in prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. As two or more agree on earth as touching anything you said, we shall have what we ask. We believe you tonight for chains to be loosed, for hearts to be set free, for lives to be changed for your glory, and for hands to be steady until the going down of the sun. We believe it tonight, and we thank you in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Aren't you glad tonight for his promises? Are you thankful tonight? Believe God. Amen. For what you prayed, believe God that he's answering, he's helping. And remember, keep your hands up. Amen. Keep your hands steady for the glory of God. And as you do, you will find that God will help you and you will prevail. Remember his word. Remember his promises. It's been good to be in the house of God tonight. God bless you. May God keep you. Thank you for joining us this evening for tonight's service. We'll see you again next time. Be it the will of the Lord and by his grace. Drive-through blessings on Saturday from 11 to 1. We'll be passing out some food for anyone that's in need. And also Sunday morning, we'll be meeting again at 11 a.m. for the Lord's Day service. Amen. God bless you. You go with God, and God will go with you.
Amen.
See you next time. Amen. God bless you tonight.